a shrimp right now. So
I can't have it.
But I'm just so grateful for all the hard work. I remember the fire, and I remember the folks being displaced here, and I remember all the concerns in the wake of the fire, which were all very predictable and understandable, that whether this place would have to be demolished. And it is it's a remarkable piece of architecture. It's a remarkable block in our city. Is this Georgian? No, it's
Greek Revival.
Is it Greek? It's Greek. Oh, okay, yeah, of course, like everything else. Yeah, but it's a window into a really fascinating time in New Bedford's history. You know, there's a picture of New Bedford in the 1830s and the bustling streets, and picture like right around the exact same time. This is when Frederick Douglass came to this very neighborhood. That's what it was like back then, and he describes it in some detail. So if you ever want to know what it was like when this house was built, read the narrative of Frederick Douglass, and the last chapter goes into a great deal of detail about this particular block, or set of blocks right here. And it was a bustling, fascinating place, and prospering place, and we want to do everything we can to preserve it just so, because it's a big part of our identity. But it's not easy. It's not easy given the nature of the real estate market in the city, and it's not easy just because it's so expensive to undertake one of these restorations. And so that's why it really requires a team effort. And I don't mean to sound cliche about it; it really does. And this is so I can't possibly do it justice and name everybody who's been involved, but I do want to cite just a few people, for their really hard work. TRI under Mike's leadership has done some really interesting stuff in the city. He's put off some projects that I think would have daunted a lot of other folks. And again, this is a part of our history. And I know Mike really appreciates the need for preservation, the power of preservation to create community and make people feel good about their place, which is what we're trying to do in the city right now. And so, Mike, I really want to thank you for your leadership and your vision in helping make that happen. And for folks at Rail, Terry, Andy, the rest of the board, everybody, you guys, you've heard me say at other ribbon cuttings, and I'll continue to say it, Rail is back in business because you guys have really stepped up and understood the core mission of the organization and the potential here in New Bedford for Rail to really to bring back to life buildings like this, especially a building like this that was so distressed. So thank you, and more to come, more ribbon cuttings to come. We'll bring back the big scissors for every one of them. It'll be a pleasure.